Hello guys, my name is Chico Lopez. If you've never been to this channel, you're welcome to the channel. We make videos here in regards of the American Pitbull Terrier, the real American Pitbull Terrier, the real Pitbull. I'm gonna have a series of videos that I'm gonna be making that are gonna help you understand the real American Pitbull Terrier. And so I'm gonna go through different videos that I'm gonna make today in English and in Spanish for my both channels. I have a channel in English and I have a channel in Spanish as well. I used to have only one in English, but the demand in Spanish is so big that we started making the one in Spanish as well. My website, to get these things out of the way, is therealpitbull.com. You can find me on chicolopez.com as well. I want to get through this here quickly. I know I mentioned this in other videos, but if you haven't seen the other video, I'm going to recommend you to watch, to read this book here. It's called The Sport Gene. It was recommended to me by my friend Del Brastrom, and it's an amazing video. It's an amazing video that talks about the mutant gene in Afro-Americans in Jamaica and how the African man is so powerful and so strong. You know, let me get into the meat and potatoes of this video today. Today we're going to talk about, on this list that I have a list of things that I'm going to go through my videos. And today we're going to talk about what people call the XL Pitbull, okay? And in reality, let me just correct this so we can start the proper way. There is no such a thing as XL Pitbull. Let me make sure that we do understand this part. There's no such a thing as XL Pitbull. And you might say, in many times in all my videos, and if you probably see this video in a different channel, somebody shared this video, and you're looking at this video in a different channel, some of the things that I'm gonna say are gonna be repetitive for the people that are in my channel. I saw my credentials in the American Pitbull Terrier. Most condecorated dogman in the history of the breed. You know, whenever you go and see, you are looking for a dieting video, you know, how to get in shape, how to lose weight. Obviously, you're gonna look for the videos that are made for the doctors. You know, a doctor made a video, you're gonna look at that video, you're gonna look at his credentials, you're gonna look up about the things that he has done in the past, books that he wrote, what was his influence, where did he work with. So I look at all these things before I make my decision and say, I'm gonna buy this idea, I'm gonna work with it, right? And it's very important for everyone to have that kind of process. You're gonna have a process if you want to look at something and say, well, I'm looking at this right here, okay? And the topic is the American Pitbull Terrier. How I treat the topic is extremely important. You know, the casual guy is one of the worst things that happen is someone that really do not know how to make decisions. You know, they look at something and they fall in love with that something that they seen. They didn't do their homework, they didn't do the background check and do everything, you know, to make a smart decision. And so I look at the dog and I say, I like the size of the dog, I like the head of the dog, I like, you know, you always gotta make a smart decision. And when it comes to the double X Pitbull, and let me just take that, I use the double X Pitbull as a phrase because that's how you know it. That's how it's in the market, right? Not necessarily that there is such a thing as double X Pitbull. That is not a Pitbull. You must understand that there is a very complex and defined definition of what is the Pitbull. The information out there on the internet is extremely, extremely crazy. Yesterday, somebody sent me a link about a gentleman that made a video about the real American Pitbull Terrier and his understanding of what it was the American Pitbull. I mean, anybody can make a video. You know, we're in a society where social media came in, you know, before I got into the dogs and I came from a different world, and we used to get the news from the major channels, you know, CNN, Fox, whatever the case might be. And of course, those guys were lying for most of the things. Sometimes they were giving us news and stuff. And it was the type of thing where we're going through an awakening. A lot of you guys, millennials, will understand what I'm talking about. But then again, we run into a different problem. We run into the problem that before, like when somebody was going to talk about, let's say, who's the best horse in the world, right? The best horse in the world will be measured by the performance. And the people that will measure the horse, it will be experts that have authority on that area of expertise. And that great horse will be measured by strictly his performance. You know, how he did in social competitive race, how many horses were running on that particular race, right? So, music, please. Adjust the music here so I can have my thing rolling. Sorry about that, guys. So, when we have these type of decisions, you know, the experts, you know, the guy, who's the guy that's talking about this genetic composition on this horse? When you're looking at a horse, you're looking at genetics, you're looking at the performance, you're looking at the quality of that horse, right? And so it used to be that we will get that information from the experts. Today is a little different, you know, and it's a dangerous world because anybody, any yo-yo, you know, we're in Brazil here, and not to say nothing, but you know, the guy that sells me the meat and potatoes, he also has a Facebook account, he also has an Instagram account, he also has a YouTube account, he has his own opinion on how, you know, how to have a racehorse or how to have a dog and so on and so forth. That makes it a huge problem because anyone can make a video with their idea, with their interpretation, and that's not going to be backed by the understanding, by the performance, by the numbers, by the merits, by what really matters. You know, there are some things in the world that are relevant and some things that are irrelevant, you know. When it comes to, like I said before, nutrition, and you know, I was looking for someone that'll help me lose the weight that I gained, and I'm going on that road right now. And you know, there was thousands of people with different ideas on what I needed to lose weight, right? And then I found this great doctor, and then before I went to him and anybody else, I make sure that I was talking to the right guy. I wanted to talk to that guy, the person that really knows. You know, do this and do that and so on and so forth. This worked for this guy, this worked for the other guy. It was not important to me. I wanted to know who was the best. That was very important. The same thing when I got into the dogs and the American Pitbull Terrier, and I said this in many of my videos, my mission was only one. I wanted to own the very best of the best American Pitbull Terrier. That's what I wanted to own. I didn't want to own, you know, what somebody thought it was a good dog, or even what I thought it was a good dog. You know, and this part is very important, so you pay attention. You know, I doubted my own opinion of what it was, the real American Pitbull Terrier. I tell you a little something. There was a magazine from one of the, I don't want to mention the name, you know, from one of the organizations that registered dogs, and this company had a magazine, advertised before in that magazine. And they had this magazine, right? And so that was handed to me when I started the dogs in 1993, 94. And they handed me these magazines. And they were a little older, of course, when I got them in 94. They were a little older. And this magazine had a whole bunch of advertising, right? And on this advertising, they had advertising. This was an American Pitbull Terrier magazine, right? But they had the advertising of dogs like from Graveyard and you know, Machine Gun Kelly and Racer Rage and all this garbage. And so I was confused. I was like, oh my God, you know, this is a magazine for pit bulls. And I look at this stuff, you know, you were so confused. The guys that wrote the magazine themselves didn't know exactly what a real American Pit Bull Terrier was. You know, most of the desk people have no idea, really. They're only lookers. Somebody tell them something, they trust somebody, but they really don't have the expertise. So they, and then, you know, when it comes to advertising, people will put anything on a magazine for advertising, right? As long as you're paying, that goes in there, right? Regardless whether it's a real pit bull or it's not a real pit bull, whether it's a high quality pit bull or low quality pit bull, you're paying, you're in the magazine, right? So when you come and, you know, I look at these dogs, you know, I called the guy in Florida, and he was selling me a dog for, it was like $1,500, $1,000. And I'm talking about 1994, 95, maybe at the time when I got the magazine. And it was a big head dog, you know? And I went to the pet shop and I look at this collar with all the spikes and everything. It didn't feel right. It didn't feel right, but that's what everybody was doing. When I was young, you know, I was like 22, 20, 21, 22 years old. And then all of a sudden, you know, I was so fortunate that somebody that actually knew about pit bulls. At the time, for me, that person knew a lot, you know, and every time, you know, I meet somebody that knows about dogs, then more and more and more and more, until, you know, I created this image of this great dogman called Chico Lopez that had to be the very best dogman in the world, best breeder, by performance, by merits, by being authority, by earning the right? So going to this process, and I'm just telling you the story so you can understand the process of selecting what is a real American Pitbull Terrier and why opinions don't matter. Now, I told you that time that was the magazine that had the wrong information. Today, you guys, maybe never open the magazine. You go on Instagram, you go in YouTube, you go to forums, and you see 14,000, 40,000 members, and all of a sudden you're in shock because you make the mistake thinking that consensus means the truth, and that is not true. That's one of the biggest mistakes. So I'm educating you right now. I've got all the businesses and industries that I want to be working on, and I'm not going to forget my American Pitbull Terriers. but I decided to make this great video so I can bring you the information that matters. And I want you to share this video, because you need to have people that actually understand the real American Pitbull Terrier. And you say, you know what? There's a guy by the name of Chico Lopez. He really knows, he got the merits. He was looking for the very best of America. If you want just a regular dog, any dog that anybody can have, that's different. But if you are really looking for the very best, then you need to listen to me, because I paid the price. I got the merits. You know, I am that guy that, you know, would have been horses, secretariat. You know, I own that collection of great dogs. And so when it comes to that double X pit bull or double X dog, that's just straight garbage. And some people are like, oh my God, how can you call it a straight garbage? Because it really is. Look, man, it's very simple. You know, you walk into Kentucky, right? And you got these Arabian horses, and you got these farms where you got these great horses. And you know, they have this vision of what's great. They have this image of the greats because they've seen them. And you can study yourself a little bit about horses, you can understand. They know the image of, you know, Men of War, you know, Seabiscuit, Secretariat. And today, Ron Happy, that belongs actually to a good friend of mine and mentor, Mr. Jim McAmbell. So when you look at this, you know, you gotta earn the right. You know, Claiborne Farms is where Secretariat was born, this gray horse. Take a look at the movie. Go in the movie, go on Netflix, and you order the movie called Secretariat, and it's about a racehorse. So you get the spirit and the understanding. You look at another movie called Seabiscuit, right? So when you're looking at these amazing animals, you understand that, for instance, Ron Happy, where the stable where Secretariat used and was raised, and that's where he started his career, and his father, Bald Ruler, was in that particular stable. That stable is prime. It's prime, the best of the best in the whole world when it comes to horses. So the very best guys wants to have their horse there, right? Because it's empty, and it's been empty for a long time, and there's a lot of people that have been going through the stable and putting these, you know, taking pictures, because it's an empty stable, it's a historic stable. So people that understand the spirit of genetics and performance and race horses, they go to that place, right? So when it comes to horses, you know, my friend had this amazing horse called Ron Happy, and they call him and you say, you know, listen, we want you to take one, we want to get your horse, having it as a stud, because he earns the right being the best, got the right, best numbers, and we want to provide this stable one so he can stay there in that stable because he earned the right. So everything in life is the same way when it comes to dogs. It's even more important, right? And the difference is that, you know, when you buy in a racehorse, you're spending $200,000, then the horse becomes mega famous. Now the horse is worth, you know, $100 million in stud fees and producing and so on and so forth, and maybe a movie in Hollywood or whatever. So when it comes to dogs became something that anybody can have a dog. So the question is, you know, this channel is not for anybody. This channel is only for great people, you know, and basically when I sell dogs, for instance, I want the person to be a CEO, to be somebody of education, to be a founder, to be an entrepreneur, you know, to be a businessman. And if you're a worker, that you're driving a truck and, you know, you're putting your hours, you're putting your time, you want to have the best, yes. You know, it's not for the broke down. You know, my culture is so different from what they used to have back in the days with the dogs, where they're looking for, oh, you know, want a dog for the working man. Look, man, the working man, the guy that's living paycheck to paycheck, he can't have a dog. Most ridiculous stuff I ever heard in my life is like, the working man. Working man, forget about you. You need to get it. You know, you have children that you shouldn't have because you can't even feed yourself. You can forget about dogs. It's not going to be your pastime, you know, fighting dogs and doing stuff. And forget it. Or just having dogs or raising dogs. We're not going to go in that direction. So I don't work with the working man, because I am a working man. But the definition of a working man is a miserable guy that's willing to bet, you know, $10,000-$15,000 in a dog fight, but he wants to get a dog for $500. And that's scumbag. I don't want it with me, you know? And that's why I don't sell to dog fighters. That's why I don't sell to breeders. Oh, I'm a dogman. You know, first thing you tell me you're a dogman, I don't want to talk with you. You're already contaminated. You already got the wrong culture. Oh, I'm a breeder. Forget about you. Don't want to do nothing with you. I don't care about your bloodline. I don't care about what you know. Do not, you know, and then some guy put price, you know, price. That dog that just put price, couldn't communicate himself. I don't want to do nothing with that guy. I want to talk to the guy that really makes sense. I want to talk to the best guy. So I make these videos to provide those people that are really smart, the new generations. Some of these old generations, you can't rescue them. You can rescue these old generations. These folks that already have 20 dogs, 10 dogs, been breeding dogs, this garbage, maybe there's one that can come and say, you know what, you know, I want to have a great dog. You know, I've been living in the world of garbage. Every pitbull that I ever had, it was total trash. And, you know, I did it because that's what I found. And really wasn't my fault because, you know, but, you know, I've been in the dogs for 20 years. If you create a reputation of breeding dogs, dogs that have sex and having puppies and sharing them with the neighborhood, selling them, giving them away, I'm not going to do business with you. But if you're the type of person that wants to have the very best for yourself, I will do business with you. Only as long as you're not leaking my bloodline, my work, you're keeping it for yourself, and you're a good person, I'm going to interview you. People are like, I want to know how much your dogs. You're going to go through the interview process with me. Because I'm not going to just throw prices without you knowing what you're buying. But I want to know who you are. Maybe you don't qualify to buy my dogs. Many people call and say, yeah, I got money, I got cash. I don't need that. I want to know who you are. So anyhow, going back to the topic on the XL pit bulls. There's no such a thing. Every single website, and I challenge all of you guys that have websites, you come here to check my videos. I challenge you guys that had this video, these pages, where you have these double X pit bulls, really, or all double X dogs. Look, you have garbage. You really, all your websites, everything you have, you don't have no heritage. You don't have great dogs behind it. The registers that register your dogs, they're like 20 years, 30 years maximum. There's no backbone. There is nothing, you know, you mix these dogs with that dog to create a sign. You can't really make a real American Pit Bull Terrier into a 100-pound dog. You can't do that. You really can't do that. You know, an XL Pit Bull is like, my wife just told me, it's like junk food. It's garbage. You know, you can't call food that is bad for your body junk food, because it's really not food, it's just poison. So it's junk. So these dogs here, the double XL, is completely garbage. And I'm going to title this video, and I, you know, you any kennel that's selling XL pit bulls and XL dogs, whatever, you're selling garbage. You don't know nothing about dogs. You know, you were born in that deal. And you know, and I'm not gonna be able to help you. You know, don't call me and tell me, you know, I wanna start breeding your dogs and this and that. I'm not gonna be able to help you. You know, you are already too totally screwed up. So this video is for people that wanna have the best, only the best, and it's an educational video to teach those people which is the road to go. You know, if I was gonna buy a horse, I would buy a horse from the farms that are making the best race horses in the world. I'll go to Kentucky, I go to the auctions, and I look at the experts, I ask the experts, I get the right information, go into the right direction. When it comes to the American Pit Bull Terrier, everything that says kennel this, kennel that, you know, really, there's not one. You couldn't sell me a dog from anybody in the world, you know, because I have so many. I'm gonna make sure the videos, I'm gonna continue talking about this, so the video is not too long, but I'm gonna put topics in my other videos, so make sure you watch my other videos, and please share this to someone that you care, because sharing is caring. And my name is Chico Lopez. I'm very excited, by the way. I'm going to different businesses. I already have two businesses, and I'm going to other businesses. And I'm gonna be recruiting people and leaders. I'm gonna develop leaders. And I'm gonna develop this breed to a level that nobody ever done. I'm gonna take it to magnificent, faraway levels. So I wanna say thank you very much for your time. Again, my website, therealpitbull.com. My phone number, if you want to call me, I'm always busy. You can leave me a message and I will take and I'll call you back if I can right away. If I cannot, I'll have my wife call you back or someone that's assisting me. But we'll get back with you. And if I haven't get back with you, I am so sorry. You know, I travel a lot. Today I'm here. Tomorrow I'm going to be in China and so on and so forth. Very busy person. But hey, guys, main thing is this. Remember this. Only the best. When it comes to the real American Pit Bull Terrier, it's only one thing that matters. It's only the best. And everything that's out of only the best, in the outside of this, only the best, that is very protected, everything is completely garbage. Because, you know, the good is the enemy of great. Good is the enemy of great. If you don't believe me, buy the book, okay? Good is the enemy of great. Take from good to great. Thank you very much, guys. God bless you. God bless America. God bless the great people. God bless the people that want only the best. Thank you so much. Chico Lopez.